Hello everyone, I'm Eliana Rich and welcome to my channel. This star online is called Who Are They? And this is about the new people in your life who you don't know very well, and you just met each other and you would like to know what kind of people they are. Should you trust them? Is it safe to be around them? What you can expect from them? And I will use to get all the answers for those questions the tarot deck, which is called Art Nouveau, and I will combine them with this dice casting. Dice casting is came to us from the ancient Indian Egypt, and the first dices were made from the animal bones with the different numbers or symbols carved on them. Today I will use these plastic ones and I will not use that color psychology today, so the color doesn't mean today anything. I will need just to know to see the numbers of the dice, right? We have two options, number one and number two. So you can assign two people different ones, or one of them to number one or to number two. Below the video, you can find the timestamps. Okay, let's get started. I'm gonna pull out the significator, which will give us a short general description of the person. What kind of person it is. Okay, for the number one and for number two. What kind of person? Oh, this person is, you know, very disappointed in her or his life. So at this moment something happened maybe, and you know, like very hurt person, you know, maybe it was broke up recently, or maybe something happened in their life, so they still have this pain in their soul, you know. But if it's not about that, it's about this person, this kind of person who is, you know, always thinking in a negative way about something. It's possible, right? And never believes like something good will happen. It's always prepared for the negative results. Or it's the people who are very acceptable to any situations. They can accept anything, right? They're not scared to accept anything what might happen in their life, which is a very strong person, which is a strong quality to be like that, right? So it's interesting. But in general, these people who likes to start something new, they're always thinking about something new. They're very sharp-minded people. They're quick thinkers. They're very clean, I mean, in their minds, right? They never drowsy. They never, you know, delusional, I mean. So they're always very, they know very, you know, clearly their plans, what they want, what they need, what is good, what is bad, and they might be very abrupt sometimes, but very straight and honest people. All right, let's see now, let's ask a few questions. So what do they think about themselves? It's interesting, right, to know. What do they think about themselves? Okay, they think they're not easygoing people. They think they're very changeable. They think they can change their life completely if they want it, if they're ready, if they will decide to do so. Some of them think they're very creative, innovative people. They're thinking in a different ways. They can think far forward, you know, they can calculate everything in advance. Some of them think about themselves like that's, if they offended, it's not easy for them to forgive people who hurt them, right? So this is like that. Okay, let's see. How do others see them? People around them, what do they think about them? Devil. By this devil, people can think about them. They're very hard workers. They're working so hard. So, you know, like they never complain. They never think how bad it is or no, because they have their goals and they will do it. They will keep doing because they, at any cost, you know, even if it's not comfortable for them, they can keep doing it. By devil, they think about them like they can be angry, they can be impulsive, they might be very addictive to something, addictive to work or to relationship, or they might be very jealous, and they can show their that negative emotions, and they're very energetic, you know, and very powerful and impressive for people, but not all the time in a good way. It doesn't mean people see them as devils. No, a devil, it's about like you're very addictive, obsessive, jealous, strong, hard workers. Okay? What is bad about their behavior? What is bad? They can hesitate. Even we see, right, by this card, they're very clear thinking and sharp minded, but still this person, particular person, very hesitating before to make any decisions, never makes decisions to be on emotions, you know, very unemotional approach, very analytical, will compare everything, will weigh, research, but never will be in a rush to make any decision. So always hesitating, doubting about everything before to make a decision. That's a great, I think it's a good thing, you know. So very rarely they can make mistakes. But this is card about bad behavior. It means they're doubting maybe a little bit too much. They're not self-confident, right, about themselves. Okay, what is important for them right now? What is their priority for now when we're watching this video? Priorities are changing, right, quickly. Priority, probably this person has started to work on something new. Maybe she or he has new idea, new project, you know, something new what this person or started to do, just the beginning, or maybe just thinking to start, but very close to that. It didn't bring any results for today, for this day, right? Because we cannot see no any greens, no plants, nothing right here. But it might be very promising in the future. This is the priority about something new. Okay, how about what they don't care about at all? What they don't care about? They don't care about money. It's interesting, you know, these people, they are they like the results by itself. When they're working on project, they want to see the results, and they never thinking about the reimbursement. They don't think about money. They know it will come, but it's not like a first thing in their mind about money or material life. No. Okay. It's like a hermits, right? By hermit, they're the same. They are about the theory, about the result, about the project. Money, it's later. If you will pay me, great. And here is the same. And another information by this card, they don't care if they're working on something, on some project, some work, some relationship. They don't care about how long it might take. They will keep doing it. You see, but the devil's quality. They will keep doing at any cost to get the results. Okay. What qualities do they have to be proud of? Four of Swords. Okay, this is also almost like this one. They like, and this one, you see this, all three cards are resonating, right? So the good quality, what they can be proud of, they knows when to take time out, you know, when to pause it, when to step back, what is the right moment to stop or to step aside, don't be involved, you know, to be silent, you know, to take time to think over, to check everything, right? And they know when to stop. This is a very amazing quality because they're so smart. By Source, they're very smart, very sharp-minded, as I said, right? They think very quickly and unemotionally, very logical, analytical approach to everything. Don't let their emotions to be involved. Okay, now let's see what needs to be improved. Hospitality, you know, they need to be more, you know, to show, to be more sincere. But when I'm saying sincere, it doesn't mean they are fake. No, it means they have to show their emotions, their, you know, mutual interest, their warmness, their hospitalities, like they like people. They have to show a little some emotions and to be opened to people. You see, by this card, they have to be open to invite them, to be social, to be flexible, to be warm, you know, to be communicative. This is what they have to improve a little bit. Now let's ask, are they generous? When I'm talking about generosity, it's not about like to come and bring you money or presents, right? Not only financial, material life. When we're talking about generosity, it's about to be generous, to share with something, to share with some ideas, to share with some advices, to share with some information which they know. This is generosity as well, right? Okay, are they generous? Yes. If they want. So no, by magician, they have all resources, all abilities, everything at their hand to be generous, to share. They have a lot to share. But they will share only if they will decide. So they're very, very selective. But mostly, this is positive card. Mostly, yes, they are generous. They're not stingy at all. But they're very selective, you know. Which is smart, I think. Okay, next questions. Will they be successful in the future? This person, right? Will they be successful? Oh, it's not gonna be easy for them. At least in the near future, they will fight, they will keep doing, they will keep trying to be socially realized, to get, you know, to approach the big goals. But a lot of work in front of them. It's not gonna be easy at all. Not so far, doesn't look like. Okay, now let's ask. Using the dice casting. Question. Will they help you if you will need some help? If this person will help you when you will need it. Okay. Yes, this person will help you if you will need your or his help. Great. Let's ask why. Why? Because he's all very selective, right? Why? Because you make these people to feel good. Maybe you are always there to help to this person, and it will be like a mutual help to you. Maybe you make this feel you're always encouraging this person by words, by actions, just being together. By this card, it's saying because you are making these people to be like that, you know, to be winner, triumpher, to be successful. So great feelings, and always will want to help you. Okay, next question. Is it safe for you to be around this person? When I'm asking about is it safe, it's a different, right, meanings. For some of you, this meanings like literally if it's safe, if this person is not crazy, right? Or for some of you, this maybe this person can be betrayal, you know, can betray you and hurt you. I don't mean physically, or like it's person who you cannot trust, so that's why it's not safe. So let's ask, if is it safe for you to be with this person? Okay. It's 50-50. So sometimes you can trust to this person fully, completely, right? But sometimes there will be some situations when this person will need to win. You know what I mean, right? This person will do everything for himself or for herself at any cost. That's why it's 50-50. If it will be situation when this person is not interested in you, that's fine. But if you will be on their way, it might work against you. Okay? Okay. Will you be together? Will you be in touch with this person? It doesn't matter in which status. Maybe you're partners, right? Or business partners, or just friends, or just neighbors, you know? So let's see if you will be in touch. If you will be together. No. The answer is no. So you're not gonna be in touch. You're not gonna be friends or together, like very closely. Why? I think you see the answer, right? Because you will be maybe for some reason, maybe you will be in some situation competitors. Maybe it's too much jealousy. Maybe you're just two different people and this person is a little bit too tough for you. Maybe you just will not find agreements in some fields, right? It's different point of views, you know, it's different opinions, different visions, different, you know, values, different conceptions, different understanding, what is value, what is not. So you just will not find the compromise with each other. And so that's why you will not be together. You will not be in touch. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel, leave your comments, and I wish you to be around the right people. But now we're gonna do for the number two. Let's see, what kind of person this? Oh, this is the successful person, absolutely successful by the Chariot. This person is a leader, very energetic, very ambitious, very strong, very pushy, you know, forceful person who never will stop. Sometimes maybe a little bit too much aggressive, maybe a little bit too much tough, too much... wants to get everything at once, immediately, right away, quickly, right? Cannot wait. And so these people, they usually use the all possible and impossible resources to achieve their goals. So it's good to be with such people around because you will grow with them. They never stop to grow. They're always improving themselves. They're doing great all the time, very great. Okay, let's see, what do they think about themselves? Yeah, the same, they're very adequate, realistic people, very ambitious, goal-oriented. It's very important for them to be socially realized. The first priority for them is their career, and then later maybe family. But if they're married, they're very, they can do both in a good way. So these people very charm, very talkative, communicative. They know how to talk to people. They know how to find right approach to them, to different people from different levels. They're so flexible, social, open. They're always around a lot of people, very respected, too much ambitious. But which is good because it's a strong motivation for them, you know, to grow, never stop. Okay, how do others see them? They see them very successful people because they are successful. They can see this person has everything, like great family, great financial status, great social status, love, respect, money, wealth, health, and everything, like a full package of everything. This is how people can see them. Interesting. Okay, let's ask, what is bad about their behavior? What is bad? What is bad, they might be very, you know, conservative or traditional or very stubborn in their ideas or in their principles, in their conceptions. So it's very difficult to make them to change their mind or to change their opinion or to change their vision. They're a little bit too stubborn about their own vision and opinion. What is important for them right now? What is the priority? What is their priority? The priority is, you know, to keep under control everything around them, to be very smart, analytical, move forward and to try to calculate everything, to manage and control and handle without any emotions. Don't let to be emotional, like don't let themselves to be impulsive. So very cold, logical, smart, straight, and moving forward quickly. Wow, okay. What they don't care about. They don't care about money for right now, about some, you know, to spend a lot of money for something. If they want to buy something, they will buy. And they don't think how much it is, how it might disbalance their financial status. Yes, they can be very extravagant with their financials. Okay, if so, let's ask, are they generous? Are they generous? But when I'm talking about generosity, it's not about like to give money or presents, right? It's about generosity of to share with something, share with information, share with some advices, share with some possibilities, you know? It might be anything. Generous? Not really. No. This person knows how to count money, how to count the value information, how to keep them in, how to share very selectively. Okay. What qualities do they have to be proud of? What qualities to be proud of? They're fighters, yes, of course, by chariot, of course, they're leaders, they're fighters, they're the best, they're very good, you know, competitors, they're always in competition with something, and they very, very determined, you know, to win, they're very eager to approach their goals, so, and they never will fight, they will never stop to improve their skills, knowledges, and their status and position. They're always fighting to be better, higher, smarter, wiser, you know, just like that people. Okay, what needs to be improved? What needs to be improved? They need to be, you know, a little bit positive. Maybe they too focused on their career or what they're doing right now, right? In their priorities. And they keep forgetting, you know, to celebrate, to be happy for small things, to be happy for something, you know, routine, small things, right? To be around friends, to hang out with your classmates or with your family, with your relatives, you know, just to find any reason to celebrate, to drink, to dance, to laugh. They're too focused on their goals and they cannot let themselves, you know, to relax. Okay, so will they be successful in the future? Will they be successful in the future? It's interesting because we can see how they're determined, right? Let's see. Oh yeah, they will be, but not that. No, okay, for everyone is a different level, right? They will keep working. They never will stop working and improve themselves, right? The same resonating card, they're saying the same. They will be very hard workers all the time, non-stop. They will always find something to improve to. They always be working on their skills, knowledge, making their financial ground stronger, right? Solid. And they always will be working. But for some of them, it's going to be their own business. So they will be successful, very successful in their own business. Now let me ask, using this dice casting, I would like to ask, will they help you if you will need them? Will they help you if you will need them? The answer is 50-50, so they will be very selective. Sometimes they will help you immediately. Sometimes they will refuse. They will step aside, you know. And let me ask, why? Why they are very selective with you? Huh. On one hand, it's saying they will help you because they can see if the situation will be, you know, profitable or good for them. If they will be interested in that situation to help you, they will help you. If not, they will say, I'm sorry, not for this time. They're very selective. Okay. Now, let me ask. Is it safe for you to be around this person? Safe for you. I can't say it's not safe, but it's, you know, it's like, so if you will be on the way of this person will not think about like your friends or partners or something. There is might be some situation when you will be sacrificed by this person, you know. So that's not good to be on their way, to be in competition with this person. But it doesn't mean it's dangerous. Just you have to be prepared for that, right? You have to expect from this person, like this person will not let you to take their position. What I mean. Okay, will you be together as partners or as friends or, you know, to be in touch? Will you be together? It's a 50-50. It means you will be in touch rarely, sometimes, but you're not gonna be close friends. You're not gonna be very, you know, connected to each other. But you're not gonna be separated fully. You will be in touch. And let me ask why? How it will go? Because you want to think in a good way about this person. And this card is saying you want to believe like this person is good to be around, right? But this card is saying be careful, you're a little bit delusional about that. All right? But there is nothing bad at all. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel, leave your comments, and I wish you to be around right people, very reliable, very responsible, and lovely ones. Thank you for watching. Bye.